think that Tomorrowland is a festival where it's impossible to get in and to leave as the same person. It's almost like living in a different kind of reality.
Tomorrowland healed myself when I was in my lowest. For many people, it can change their life forever.
Even in this difficult period, it's important to find something what gives you energy, what gives you positive emotions. To feel everything like it's true, and I'm a part of this.
I've been coming here since 2014, and I haven't missed a weekend since. I feel like this is my family, this is my home, and it makes me who I am.
I'm trying to bring a new version of Hear Me Now. It's a hit, and a hit never gets old. You just have to like refresh it. So specifically for Tomorrowland, I'm doing something high energy. More like psytrance, you know? I'm still using the base of psytrance, but I brought a little bit more of, you know, like the Eurotrance elements. This one here, it fits very well. I often work here because my life is being just very intense. The rhythm is just too intense. If I was stuck in studio at this rhythm, I wouldn't have time to spend with my kids. It doesn't make sense, you know, to leave this routine and don't have them around me, you know. It's not so easy sometimes, but yeah, I can manage it. I mean, my parents, they managed to raise me on psytrance festivals all over the world. Of course, I'm able to do it as well. Yeah. My parents, they're pioneers of the electronic scene. My dad also runs a festival called Universal Parallelo, which means like parallel universe. They are like the legends. They started the psytrance scene in Brazil. I started to also perform when I was very young, 12 years old. I have a twin brother and he started DJing with me. We had a project called Logica and it was going very well. So I was raised in this, right?
Today I'm not sure, but I am now as father of Alok. Nah. I go to the parties. Hey, you father of Alok? Yes. I can make a picture of you? Yes, but you know my name? Oh, no, well, no, don't take a picture. joke, I make
no,
it.
He's just kidding, he's a legend. What I do nowadays is the continuous of his story and my mom's story, so.
I'm very, I would say, blessed to have my family. The only way I could be Alok myself is exactly because of this. Because I had those parents. And I'm very thankful for everything that happened, even though like all the hard moments that happened as well, because it wasn't easy.
It was the first time we ever went to a rave.
In Amsterdam.
In Amsterdam. Quantos anos a gente tinha?
Vocês deviam ter seis ou sete.
Basically, when I was very young, I moved to Amsterdam with my brother and my mom. My parents, they broke up when I was four. As we were illegal, we were living in a squat with an international hippie community, you know? It was actually amazing because I was raised in a very freedom atmosphere, you know? But when I came back to Brazil, all this freedom in this society was unacceptable. My parents, they were just too different. And I was very many times like complaining why they were not just normal people having ordinary jobs, and you know, and it was very complicated for me because I was just trying to find myself into the society, you know. Thank God I had my brother and he had me. Since we were very young, we had to support ourselves a lot. The moments that there were no one looking after us, we were looking after us. So when we broke up, our project Logica, it was so hard for me, you know? Like I had to do only 50% of things in life. The other 50, I was always counting on him. So this moment was the moment where after a few years, when he got on stage, surprise. It was super, super emotional. But once again, I could only create Alok because I passed through this experience, otherwise I would be in a comfortable zone, I would still go in with Logica. I just felt a little bit limited and I just wanted to spread more and connect with more people. You know what's interesting about him now? It was the vehicle for me to access these different places, to cross all these barriers of the electronic and go into the pop world. I think I'm addicted to connect with people. It's the way that I found myself fitting in the society, yes. If you were born in a world where you don't fit in, maybe you're here to create a new world. And it's basically what I feel about Tomorrowland. A place where you can be.
I really love the part that Tomorrowland changed every single aspect of my life. Until last year, I was living in Peru, and voila, I'm here in Belgium right now. Living in the country of Tomorrowland, not just enjoying the festival, but also enjoying the life with the person that I love. We have been cooking together for seven months,
yeah.
Something like that, yeah.
It was a Peruvian invasion.
I've never expected that I will live in another part of the world. And yeah, I do miss my country, and especially my friend Elizabeth. Actually, Elizabeth was the friend that I went to Tomorrowland Brazil with. Because of her, right now I'm here. She gave me the hope that I needed. She gave me that view that I didn't have for myself. Last year, I was struggling a lot with depression. I think that for many people around the world, it was the same during the COVID time. But it was not only that. My grandmother got cancer and she was really important for everybody in the family. I had a plan to go to Tomorrowland, but in that moment I was thinking to just skip the festival, because when you are struggling with this mental illness, you don't want to do nothing and you don't even realize it. And that's when my best friend helped me a lot. She said, "You are lucky that you got tickets. We all know that life is difficult, but you are not going to stay there just suffering all the time." I knew that I could change it, but somehow I probably needed a spark, and that spark was my friend.
Hey, hey.
Hello.
And it changed everything.
It's for you.
I can say that I'm happy and healed, and I can enjoy my life again.
Let's take it.
Enjoy.
Good.
See you tomorrow, probably.
Yes.
See you
tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Hi,
Charlie. Hey, Ali. How are you?
Nervous and happy.
Carlos. Where is Carlos?
Carlos is now at a party with his friends. He's gonna party the whole evening and night. You're gonna be arriving at the Thursday, I think, right?
At evening.
Yeah. I will be there to pick you up in the airport.
Do you think Carlos think I'm going or maybe have any issues about us?
No. He doesn't suspect anything. No, nothing. So it's gonna be a total surprise if you're there.
No voy a olvidar esto.
Nadie lo va a olvidar nunca. Ouch.
My brain is still processing everything.
I can't believe it.
When I saw her face, I think that for some reason I wanted to pass out. I was like, no. I almost had a heart attack. It was like, what? No. Are you here? No. But yeah, it was so impressive. I was just shocked.
He's different for good. He's really happy now. And I'm really happy for him because it was hard in Peru.
It was really difficult to believe. I was really lost in my mind. And when I came here to Tomorrowland, it was like I left all the things that I had in my mind and I said, like, you made your own dream come true. And that's the most important proof that you have that you can be happy if you want.
There's the rules with this. So when you come into main stage, you look down. You're not gonna look up. Head down. Down. Down.
Look it down. Still looking down. Still looking down.
The whole time. Okay. We're looking down. We'll do a little hands on the shoulders. And welcome to fucking hell.
A lot to take in. Wow.
The first time standing on that hill, you don't know what that emotion is. I've been doing this for 10 years and it's still every single time, like the main stage this year. I'm Owen D'Souza. I live in Melbourne, Australia. Tomorrowland was my first festival. And I never stopped coming back. This year is very special because of my sister. She's probably been to one nightclub in her life. I have no idea. My family and my sister, I think they've seen 10 years of video, but I don't think anyone's been able to actually grasp what I was showing them. That's what makes it even extra special, being able to show them a world which is so far away from the world they live in.
I do understand why he likes coming here. Feels like he's built something as a family and friends for him. He used to be quiet. He used to be very subdued. But now he's so much out of his shell and this is who he is.
I grew up in Mumbai. I was the quiet kid that never spoke. So to express myself was a challenge, but I've learned to just put my hands up and feel the music. Your whole spirit just connects. Growing up, that's what I felt like in church. people with the same mindset, all connected together, and you're part of something beautiful. That's that feeling, and I think that's my definition of church and the place you want to be.
Wow, that is cool. Whoa!
Do you understand now?
Yeah. He was always an introvert, and he would never show his feelings. Like, he would always keep it inside. But I think it's maybe this place has got it out, and maybe that's why he feels free. That when he comes here, he just can be himself.
I'm not an emotional guy, but it's like there's only a few times I've been able to be able to express my emotions and be able to hug people and say, you know, I don't want to cry. every time I tell people, it's like, you're gonna come here, you're gonna cry, and I don't know why it does it to you, but there is something special here. And I missed Dad last year because I was standing there and I cried last year, and it was just because, now I don't know why I cried.
He would be proud though.
No, I literally stood there and I miss him.
Yep.
Dad got really sick and passed away in 2016, and he said to me, I worked really hard my whole life. I did a lot of good things, but I didn't live my own life. So go live your life. There are things out there that I can't explain. There's not enough time to show you what it all means. And that's really when I changed. So you need to get out there on your own. Make your own mind up and let your soul grow. The moment you realize that I'm not going to waste this day, I've only got that many. You don't want to be angry and don't want to be negative, and you just realize I have this time and I might as well smile. So this is why we do what we do.
I dreamed of getting to this festival for more than 6 years, but it seemed so far while living in Ukraine. Now I'm here in Belgium, so I have to take this chance. Unfortunately, online we couldn't buy tickets, so we pre-registered as volunteers. To feel like, not from the video, to feel everything like it's true. I'm here. Music for me, it's energy. It's freedom. It's something what gives you strength to move on. My name is Veronica. I'm from Ukraine, from Kharkiv. Yeah, I lived there. I had a great life before the war. There were a lot of plans for the near future, but unfortunately on February 24, I woke up from the loud explosions. Yeah. It was very scary. When we fall asleep, we didn't know if we would wake up in the morning. And so I decided that we need to live while we are alive. My mom went to central Ukraine to my grandmother. And when we were on the bus, my mom told me to go further. I ended up in Belgium alone. I didn't understand what I had to do in this life. I felt lonely, yeah, for sure. But my friend Nikolai had a grief, and so he came here.
It's not just a picture, it's real life, it's a real war. I stayed in Ukraine, but they bombed my home. I lost my father, I lost my uncle on the war. My house also was totally destroyed. I don't have anything now. I don't have a home, I don't have family, I don't have anything. Veronica is my close friend. I share with her my situation. He said, okay, I'm now in Belgium. Maybe you can try also. That's my story.
What gives me hope? It's a good question. I don't know. It's really important to me to improve my life, you know, to develop myself. I have a hope to find a good job here. That's why I continue to learn the language, step by step, you know.
Привіт, привіт.
Привіт, Веронічка.
Привіт, привіт. А ще в мене новина. Я їду на Tomorrowland, на фестиваль. Нарешті. Дякую велике. Моя мрія здійсниться. Я вже готуюсь потихеньку, купила собі наліпки на обличчя. Такі, знаєте, ну, типа, такі бльосточки, короче.
А що це за фестиваль,
Веронічка? Це фестиваль електронної музики.
Even in this difficult period, it's important to find something what gives you positive emotions. And for me, Tomorrowland, it's like a fairy tale. It's like another world where I can forget about all problems and recharge my energy, recharge my strength to move on.
Tomorrowland is the combination of so many elements that make the festival so special. Actually, the lineup, it's not at all the most important thing in the festival. You know, it's the people of tomorrow. When you have a dream, it's only a dream, but when you combine a lot of people with the same dream, it's a reality. I honestly feel I'm part of family. Every year I go there, even though it's the same place, it's the same festival, it's always a different experience.
How many times did you play Tomorrowland already, Oliver?
First time was in 14. In Brazil, I did, I think, the opening. If you have to write down like a story of my career, there's a moment before and a moment after Tomorrowland. Because like being a Brazilian and stuff, like being the main stage of Tomorrowland, it's like a very important validation. This year for sure is gonna be the best year. I feel way more prepared. But because it's not an easy dance floor. You have to bring something. But this year, I just feel way more prepared. I'm ready for it.
Papai! Papai, deixa eu te mostrar uma coisa. Presta atenção. Você vai ficar impressionado. Papai vai fazer um show agora aqui no Tomorrowland. Deixa eu mostrar pra vocês. Olha isso aqui, gente. Você viu o tanto de gente que tem ali? Papai vai entrar pra fazer o show agora, tá bom? Te amo, filho. Te amo, filha. Beijo. All the lights will die in the way. If you get to hear me now, all the fears will fade away. If you get to hear me now.
Everybody, let me see those hands.
If you get to hear me now.
I'm still gonna try to understand what happened. I'm still just downloading it because I always dream to be there in this position. And I'm finally here, it's like a dream becoming true. I'm so thankful, so blessed.
I don't want to leave.
Tomorrowland represents hope and happiness. I don't think I've seen energy like that anywhere else in the world. People talk about it and people take it home with them. And then they bring their friends. I think if we keep going at it, the world could be like Tomorrowland. I believe it's possible. We just need to believe.